Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
Ave, Ave, Maria. We pray for our country, the land of our birth. We pray for all nations that is here on earth.
Mark ourselves as a sign of God's people for us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of
you.
Lord, wish to gather us all into his Father's banquet hall, to heal us, give us forgiveness of our sins, and give us glorified bodies. Let's call to mind our sins. Thank God for the gift he wishes to give us. Lord Jesus, raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, feed us with your body and your blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, as children of our Blessed Mother, we gather before her miraculous picture to honor her and to pray for all of our needs. More than children that we are, let us first of all ask God's mercy and pardon. Merciful Father, send through your divine Son to redeem us from his death and resurrection, and to give us new life, that is, to make us your children, for all of our mother in Christ. How many times in the past we have forgotten this divine beginning? We have sinned against our brothers and sisters. We have offended you. Merciful Father, forgive us. Repenting sincerely of our sins, we ask your mercy. May we always live in the need of holy children. In our November prayer, dear Mother, perpetual help, from the cross Jesus gave to us for our mother, you are the kindest and most loving of all mothers. Look tenderly on us, your children. So now we ask you to help us to all our needs, especially this life. While you're on earth, dear Mother, you willingly shared in the sufferings of your Son. Strengthened by your faith and confidence in the fatherly love of God, you accepted the mysterious designs of his will. We too have our crosses and trials. Sometimes they almost crush us to the ground. Dearest Mother, share with us your abundant faith and confidence in God. Make us aware that God never ceases to love us, that he answers all our prayers way that is best for us. Strengthen our hearts to carry the cross, the footsteps of your divine Son. Help us to realize that he who shares the cross of Christ will certainly share his resurrection. Dearest Mother, as we worry about our own problems, let us not forget the needs of others. Those who loved others so much, help us to do the same. While praying for our intentions and for the intentions of all of your present and this movie. Earnestly ask your Mother, help us comfort the sick and the dying, give hope to the poor and the unemployed, heal the brokenhearted, lighten the burden of the oppressed, teach justice to their oppressors, bring back to God all those who have offended him. Dearest Mother, help us to avoid sin, separate us from our Heavenly Father and from one another. Full of trust in you, place ourselves on the defense. Eternal protection, and confidently hope for your powerful help. The prayer for our homes. Mother, perpetual help, we choose you as queen of our homes. We ask you to bless all our families with your tender and motherly love. In the sacrament of marriage, bind husbands and wives so closely together that they will always be faithful to each other. Love one another as Christ loves his church. We ask you to bless all parents, and they love and cherish the children.
Let us pray.
Almighty and living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our lives. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Melchizedek, king of Salem, and priest of God Most High, met Abraham as he returned from his defeat of the kings, and blessed him. And Abraham apportioned to him a tenth of everything. His name means righteous king. He was also king of Salem, that is, king of peace. Without father, mother, or ancestry, without beginning of days or end of day, of end of life, thus made to resemble the Son of God, he remains a priest forever. It is even more obvious if another priest is raised up after the likeness of Melchizedek, who has become so, not by a law expressed in a commandment concerning physical descent, but by the power of a life that cannot be destroyed. For it is testified, you are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand, till I make your enemies your footstool. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The scepter of your power, the Lord will stretch forth from Zion, rule in the midst of your enemies. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. Yours is princely power in the day of your birth, in holy splendor, before the day star, like the dew, I have begun. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The Lord has sworn and he will not repent. You are a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The trouble with Jesus, according to the Pharisees, is that the Lord wishes to invite outsiders, and that would be Gentiles that the paralytic he healed, into a new community where they share the Sabbath meal. You see, in the Jewish tradition, the Sabbath day was for God to gather his people, his family, for a meal. A man with a withered hand, according to the Pharisees, cannot be what God intended, because God created man in his own image and likeness. And God would have created the man perfect, not with a defect. Now, if the man corrupted himself by sin, that's one thing. But if the man's hand was withered from the get-go, God couldn't have done that. The man would not be invited to share the Sabbath meal. Do you see the point of the Pharisees? The man shouldn't be allowed to eat with the community and with God. But Jesus has come to restore creation, to make the man perfect, free from sin, free from illness, free from bodily defects. Whether the imperfection of man is due to a person's sinning, or some disease he caught, or if the person's problem is due to a genetic malady, or any deformation from birth, Jesus heals them, and then he eats with them. And this is all part of God's plan of salvation. The Son of God is gathering us all into a new community. It's called the body of Christ. So that his Heavenly Father can dine with us on the Sabbath. We petition our Mother Perpetua. Holy Mary, Holy Virgin, conceived without sin, our Mother Perpetual, we sinners call to you, that we may be filled with the Holy Spirit and become courageous witnesses of Christ's love for men, that we may be more and more like our Divine Lord as you are, that we may be meek and humble of heart like your Son Jesus, that we may be fear of losing God's friendship forever by our unrepentant sin. We may seek Christ's mercy and forgiveness constantly in the sacrament of penance. That we may be aware of God speaking to us in the events of our daily life. That we may pray daily with love and trust, especially in our moments of temptation. That we may realize the value of worshiping God together in the Eucharist. That we may grow in the love of Christ and our neighbor by our frequent spiritual. May we reverence our bodies as temples of the Holy Spirit. May we strive to be true Catholics by our loving concern for others. That we may proclaim the dignity of work by doing our own work conscientiously. That we may forgive from our heart those who wronged us. That we may see the evil of seeking your own interests at the expense of others. That we may work for the just distribution of this world's goods. May share our talents with others for the good of the community. That we may accept our responsibility in the community in a spirit of genuine service. To pray that the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen Pope Francis, the bishops, and the clergy. That we may be blessed with an increase of priestly and religious vocations in Sicily. That we may bring the knowledge and love of Christ to those who still do not know him. We may be aware of our dependence on God, even in the midst of our human achievements. That we may be ready at death to enter the home of our Heavenly Father. That we may die in peace with Christ and our fellow men. That we may be comforted at the death of our dear ones by our hope in the risen Lord. To pray that our departed brothers and sisters will quickly share in your Son's resurrection. Pray for the special intention of this Mass to of the soul of Betty Prendergast. Eternal rest granted to her, Lord. May she rest in peace. May Betty's soul and all the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Petition our Mother in the silence of our hearts. for the students at Sacred Heart High School and Sterling as they gather for their community mass this day. We pray also for Luke, that he had a just decision rendered in his court case. For all of your intentions, we call out, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. We'll place our Novena prayer for life here. O Mary, bright dawn of the new world, Mother of the living, to you do we trust the cause of life. Look down, Mother, upon the vast numbers of babies, not allowed to be born, the poor whose lives are made difficult, men and women who are victims of brutal violence, of the elderly and the sick, killed by indifference or out of misguided mercy. Grant that all who believe in yourself may proclaim the gospel of life, honesty, and love to the people of our time. Obtain for them the grace to accept that gospel as the gift of renewal, the joy of celebrating with gratitude throughout their lives, the courage to bear witness to it resolutely in order to build together with all people of God the civilization of truth and love to the praise and glory of God, Creator of our life. Holy Mary, help us in our needs. Pray for all the people of God. May all experience your perpetual help. Lord, you gave us Mary to be our mother, ever ready to help us. Grant us the grace to have recourse to her in all our needs. Blessed are you, O God, all creation, but through goodness you have seen the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of your hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, O God, all creation, for through goodness we receive the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work with human hands, and will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters in Christ, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and my Father.
May the Lord accept
the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of the sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you.
Together with that salvation. May our voices, we pray, join with them. Lord, be holy, Lord, with all the walls. Make holy, therefore, these things are prayer, sending down your spirit upon them like the fall, so they may become for us the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis and Pope and David, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son. we come to know and to believe in the love that God has for us.
Prayer spirits be with you.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you with all things, and I desire to be my soul. Since other people hold dear to me, I not now receive you, the sacramental. I see you come in the Spirit of into their hearts. Lord, you are in our hearts. Help us to pray and unite ourselves all to you. prayer devotion to Our Lady. Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Mother of the Church, you're also our Mother Perpetual. With hearts full of love for you, we consecrate ourselves to your Immaculate Heart, so that we may be your devoted children. Attain for us true sorrow for our sins and fidelity to the promises of our baptism. Consecrate our minds and hearts to you, that we may always do the will of our Heavenly Father. We consecrate our lives to you, that we may love God better. Live not for ourselves, but for Christ your Son, that we may see him and serve him in others. By this humble act of consecration, your Mother Perpetual, we pledge to model our lives on you, the perfect Christian, so that consecrated to you in life and in death, we may belong to your divine Son for all eternity. The prayer begins. Lord Jesus Christ, be present in the most blessed Eucharist, we adore you. And as it pleased the Father that in you all this fullness should flow, and that through you he should reconcile all things to himself. Grant us the grace to be truly grateful for all that our Father has done for us. Grant that we may be truly sorry for our sins and do penance for them. Through you we thank the eternal Father for the gift of life. He has created all the wonderful things of this world for us. May we learn to use them well, so that through them we may grow in love for him. Above all, we thank our Father for sending you to us as the greatest expression of his love, to save us and all creation by your death and resurrection. We thank you, Lord, for giving us your own Mother to be our Mother in perpetual health. And these countless favors we have received through her intercession, and especially through this movement, inspire us with greater confidence in God's love and mercy, for perpetual love. Grant that we may always do the holy will of God, and persevere in his love, to the most holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in honor, glory, and thanksgiving, forever and ever. A prayer for the sick. Lord Jesus Christ, bore our sufferings and carried our sorrows, in order to show us clearly the value of your weakness and patience. Graciously hear our prayers for the sick. Grant that those who are weighed down with pain and other afflictions of illness may realize that they are among your chosen ones, whom you call blessed. Help them to understand that they are united with you in your sufferings for the salvation of the world. Pray to St. Joseph for our happy death. Blessed Joseph, who died in the arms of Jesus and Mary, pray for me, I beseech you, the grace of your happy death. Let all our brethren and sisters, assist me by your presence and protect me by your power against the enemies and lies of the nation. To your sacred hands, living and dying, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Amen.